Hello YouTubers, and welcome to the session of T4D, or thought or tip for the day. Basically, I just want to cover off quickly, there's a few bits and pieces that have happened. The one is that the HP3457A has finally arrived, but I'll jump into that just now. First of all, there's a bit of mailbag stuff, and I do, although the gent already knows, because I have sent him an email, Warwick very kindly couriered from the UK a whole electronic circuit board and components to build a headphone amplifier for me, which I really, really appreciate. And certainly, yeah, those contributions, there have been people in the past have sent bits and pieces to me, and it certainly is appreciated. The other thing was a tip that Yves sent me, and I'll give you a close-up of a little video shot of my bench. What I've done, I've moved both the shelves about probably 15 millimeters forward to allow the power wires to drop behind so that they're not cramped up behind the equipment. And that has made a big difference. A simple little thing to do for your workbench, and something that had crossed my mind when I was putting it together, and then it kind of floated out of my mind. And then E brought it to my attention, and it makes so much sense. So thank you very much. Also, again, all the comments and collaboration and what have you in terms of the digital multimeter check, this ultimately is going to turn out, once it's a completed project, is certainly going to have been a collaboration, because there's been a lot of useful input from you guys, which I really appreciate. So I really hope that by the time I finish this project, it's going to be a really handy little device. And again, that's where the HP is going to be very helpful. So going to the HP, it finally arrived. I actually had to do a bit of running around today to go and get it. I had to eventually go and run to our central mail hub in Cape Town, kind of the customs part, to go and get it. I'll jump in with the bad news first. It has arrived in one piece, but what I'll show you in this quick little video insert is that I noticed across the front of it what I initially thought was a crack across the faceplate. And I powered it up and everything worked and what have you. And I even went to look again at the photographs on eBay, thinking, now, was that crack there when I actually purchased it and I wasn't notified about it or what have you? And when I had a look, it wasn't there, and I could see it was certainly this multimeter. It wasn't another one. And what has turned out to be, I noted that our local South African customs had opened the package to check it. The multimeter had been wrapped very well in bubble wrap, so hats off to the gent who sold it to me. I'll put his details, his eBay shop details, in the details below. They had used a box cutter to obviously cut away the plastic wrap, and they sliced across the front of the panel. So really, really irritating for a multimeter that's anywhere between 20 to 25 years old for them to have gone and done that. But I suppose I can thankfully say that they didn't slice up any of the rubber buttons and they didn't slice across the display. So it's aesthetically annoying, but functionally it works like a charm. And also, it was literally calibrated 2 days after I purchased it. I've got the certificate of calibration here. And when I say calibrated, according to this, it was intolerance when it was when they went through all the calibration criteria, which is great news. So it's intolerance, and obviously I can't really check it because I've got nothing that's accurate enough to check a 6.5/7.5 digit multimeter. But by all accounts, by the few bits and pieces I have kind of referenced to get it against, it seems to be 100%. But when the Fluke 8846A arrives, that's where I can again cross-check the 2 meters against each other to give myself absolute confidence that between the two of them, they are measuring correctly. What I will do, I will obviously go into a review on that little beastie. there's some interesting bits to note about it. I've printed out the manual. If you can't see, it's sitting on the top here. There's a lot to learn about this little thing. Even though it's a 25-year-old little beast, they built in a lot of functionality into it, and it kind of pays to understand how to use it properly. There's certainly lots of bits and pieces which I've never had to use on a multimeter or bench multimeter before, which kind of helps you get more accurate readings. So I'm going to go into that, and I'll do a review showing those bits and pieces and going into things like doing resistance measurements, both 2-wire and 4-wire, and seeing those benefits. So anyway, this is just a quick insert, and I just want to say thank the folks who had sent me little bits and pieces, the Tips Annual Collaboration. And again, if you're enjoying the videos, please give them a thumbs up, and I'll catch you soon for the next one. Cheers.